So, what did you think?
Well, first of all, let me start by commending you on taking on board such an ambitious project. To make a science fiction film, first of all, and to tell a story in under 15 minutes with a relatively small budget has to be acknowledged.
Thank you. Thank you.
But this film does have a few problems. I didn't quite get it.
Right. Okay.
I don't understand how it's a post-apocalyptic world set in the future, but it's really in the past.
Wait, it's supposed to be a dream, isn't it? That's why you've got that fade in David's eyes at the end, right?
It's not as simple as that.
I thought the characters wouldn't fully realise. Their motives were questionable.
The character's very self-contained. If you feel that they
it's
aren't...
It's just a film that doesn't seem to know what it is. Is it a social drama? Is it an art house film? Is it a comedy?
I don't find it very funny.
There's nothing funny about a cat barking.
No, it's supposed to be a very subjective film, if you ask me what genre it is.
Didn't he fire 10 rounds in a 5-round magazine?
What I don't understand is how he was trapped in that cave thing and then got back to the city with no money, no clothes, like no actual like people to help him, but apparently he can travel countries.
And what was the point in the waterfall flowing upwards?
Let's face it, the whole film is all over the place, it's in shambles, there's too many plot holes, it's an absolute mess.
Just like the continuity.
The film's title is in French because...
Well, if you look at the certain French-speaking parts...
David looks surprisingly young for someone who is supposed to be 40.
That's because he was young, he was an actor.
If Sophie and David are undercover, why are they still using their real names?
And why does Sophie speak a different language, yet there are no subtitles?
That's what I said about the title. If you actually listen...
David put on an American accent when he's clearly Welsh? And what's with the montage music? Does anyone even like Nickelback?
If you just listened, you would bloody know.
And doesn't that shower scene, technically, count as rape?
Well, only in certain counties. I mean, we filmed this in
so
East...
So more of the story is that we should recycle more.
Well, if you...
Let's face it, this film is far from being clever. It's a boring...
A poorly constructed...
Insulting...
Convoluted...
It's terrible. And
that's...
positives. While the plot is unclear at times, it doesn't take away the enjoyment you get while watching this film. The editing alone has to be praised.
Yeah, spot on, really. I mean, there's a lot going on here, especially the post-colonialism, and to an extent the sexuality of the hero and villain. And it's all set in the sci-fi genre.
I just love the risk you took with whiting up an Indian man. Such a great case of the silent movie era racism. In conclusion, you have done well. It was a confidently directed film which was fun to watch despite its plot holes.
Thank you for your comments. I hope you enjoyed what you saw.